Hi there. I have some interesting revelations in my spirit to help Calvinists. And this comes from some words by Watchman Nee in Journey Towards the Spiritual, this book right here, and on page 105 in the chapter on communion. And you can also find the same chapter in The Spiritual Man, white covers from Christian Fellowship Publishers. And the first thing I wanted to say, he doesn't say this, but the first thing I wanted to say is that at any moment in time, it's God's will that he wants you to be saved. If it could be possible, according to his holiness and righteousness, he would want every single person in the world at this very moment to be saved. So that necessarily implies that God's provided sufficient grace to every single person on the planet. Everyone's received sufficient grace. You can't say anybody's totally depraved so that God would then pass over some and elect others irresistibly. He wouldn't operate that way. That would be evil, right? Now I want to get into some juice here, if I could use that word. On page 105 of this book by Watchman Nee, in the section entitled The Holy Spirit Under Communion, the chapter on communion, he says, for 1 Corinthians 2, 9 to 3:2, he says, for verse 10, he says, God has revealed to us through the Spirit, for the Spirit searches everything, even the depths of God. This verse sets forth the fact that the Holy Spirit searches everything, and not that our minds conceives all. Only the Holy Spirit knows the depths of God. He knows what man does not know. But his intuition, sorry, by his intuition, the Spirit searches everything. God is thus able to reveal through him what our hearts have never been able to conceive. This revealing is not acquired after much thinking, for our heart cannot even conceive it. It is a revelation. It does not require the help of our thought. Keep that in line with the idea that God wants us to come to Him with an honest heart, and if we do that, He'll save us. There's no, nobody He'll resist. I mean, not save. If we all come to Him with an honest heart. The next two verses tell us how God reveals Himself. Quote, for what person knows a man's thought except the spirit of a man which is in him? So also no one comprehends the thoughts of God except the Spirit of God. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the Spirit which is from God, that we might understand the gifts bestowed on us by God, verses 11 and 12. No one knows man's thoughts except the Spirit of man. Likewise, no one knows the things of God but the Holy Spirit. Man's spirit, as well as God's spirit, apprehend things directly, not by deducing and searching. That's what our outer man does, or our mind, the mind of our soul. They perceive through the faculties of intuition, our spirit, and God's spirit. Since the Holy Spirit alone knows the things of God, we must receive the Holy Spirit if we also would know those things. The spirit of the world is cut off from the communication with God. It is a dead spirit. It cannot affect communion with Him. That's my point right there. The Holy Spirit, on the other hand, comprehends the things of God. Therefore, by receiving in our intuition what the Holy Spirit knows, we too shall understand the realities of God. Quote, we have received the Spirit which is from God, that we might understand the gifts bestowed on us by God, unquote. So the portion here that I think that I really sense something there is, it is a dead spirit. It cannot affect the communion with God. So if you're not regenerated, if your inner man is not regenerated, it cannot affect communion with, you cannot have communion with God. It's impossible. But the point there is, the point of all those verses that Calvinists use to say, if you're dead in sin, you can't ever choose God. Those verses never say that. Those verses say you can't have communion with God. The three main functions of our inner man, our spirit, is intuition, communion, and conscience. Okay? You can't have communion in your spirit with God and a relationship with Him, with spirit, making contact with spirit, because your spirit is dead. As long as it remains dead, you can't communicate with God. But nothing is preventing you from receiving the wooing of the Holy Spirit, because like I said before, God wants everybody to be saved. You see how that works? So He's provided sufficient grace to every last soul, whereas in Calvinism, He's evil. You're still not actually born again. You're in your head in a relationship. It's not a real relationship because it hasn't touched your inner woman or inner man, as the case may be. So that's the point I wanted to get across. I should read some more. I'm going to read this part too. This section here, just on page 106, the spirit of wisdom and revelation. In our communion with God, the spirit of wisdom and revelation is imperative. The quote, "The God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of Him." Ephesians 1:17. When a new spirit is received at regeneration, its functions await development, for they presently lie dormant there. The Apostle Paul prayed for the regenerated believers at Ephesus, desiring that they receive the spirit of wisdom and revelation so that they might know God intuitively. Whether this ability is a hidden function of the believer's spirit, which is activated through prayer, or whether it is something added by the Holy Spirit to the believer's spirit as a result of prayer, we do not know. It could be both, right? I'm not sure. Yet one thing is certain. This spirit of wisdom and revelation is essential to one's communion with God. We also recognize that it can be obtained through prayer. So there you have your inner man. It's not regenerated, but then you get born again and you're regenerated. You came to God with an honest heart. And then to affect this communion in your spirit with God, and so it increases through prayer. It's either activated because it's lying dormant there, and the Holy Spirit can activate it through prayer, or the Holy Spirit is activating it because He first came in when you're born again. Either way, I don't really think it matters. The important thing is, it's begun. The process has begun. You are a child of God, and your Holy Spirit is being strengthened in your inner man. I mean, and so your spirit is being strengthened by the Holy Spirit. So anyway, so the whole point of this thing that I wanted to talk about is the fact that in Calvinism, never change those verses that say you're dead to meaning that you can't receive Christ. Instead, they mean you can't have a relationship with God. First, in order to have a relationship, you're going to have to come to the cross as a helpless sinner to receive the Lord Jesus as your Savior. Amen.